You were my courage, my sword and shield, grace under pressure, my ball of steel. I was a stone weighing us down. You were the angel.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new, hi, my name is Maya, and today I'm going to be finally doing my 28 week update. Sorry that it is a day late. I've been really busy the past couple of days, and I've been kind of like late on my videos because I just haven't had any energy really to do videos since I have not been feeling too good and just been having a lot go on lately. So I'm sorry that this video is a little late, but I'm still filming it and it's still being done, so I give myself credit for being able to do this. So I have a lot to cover, so I'm just going to get right on with the video. So Grayson is about the size of a coconut this week. He is definitely getting very, very big. He's about 14.8 inches long and is over 2 pounds now. He's about 2.2 pounds. Some things that are going on is he is putting on more layers of fat. So now his skin is not super duper wrinkly and flabby. More fat is getting put onto him, so his skin isn't so wrinkly. He's also still practicing breathing for the outside world, which is good because obviously you don't want to come into the world and not know how to breathe. So his lungs are now mature enough for him to come now. So if I were to have him now, his lungs would be okay for him to be breathing and everything. He would still be in the NICU for a very long time because he would still be really, really small and everything. But he would have his lungs mature enough to come now. So, and he's also getting very bigger. He's getting way bigger, and he's also getting smarter. Like, he knows up and down. He's practicing his breathing and all of that kind of stuff. So he is getting way smarter than how he was when he was first developing, when he didn't really know how to breathe or which way was up and down. So he is learning more and more stuff, which is good because gotta learn those things. So some symptoms this week are trouble sleeping. So I have been having trouble sleeping, and it's not that I'll be asleep and I'll wake up and I'll just keep waking up and going back to sleep. What I mean by trouble sleeping is that I'm not able to go to bed at the normal time that I used to be going to bed at. I used to go to bed around 2:30, and now my schedule has changed to 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning, which is not helping me any because I'm so tired during the day now, and I honestly don't know why I'm going to bed that late. I just get distracted and get lose track of time, so I think I need to download my bedtime app and have an alarm go off at 2. If you're wondering why I was just laughing, I told Alan that there was water all over my floor and I was like freaking out, and I scared him into thinking my water broke, because that's what he thought I was gonna say when my water bottle just fell over, and it really made me mad because I had water in that. Oh god. So the next symptom is shortness of breath, and I have been getting way more out of breath lately, and it sucks. If I'm laying down, it gets hard to breathe sometimes, and I just have to sit up, and it's just annoying and I don't like it. If I'm bent over like how I am right now for a long period of time, I do get shortness of breath because he likes to move more up towards my lungs, or like where my ribs and everything are. So it's a lot of pressure, and it makes it harder for me to breathe. And even if I'm just sitting here recording a video, I do get really out of breath from talking. It's a lot of being out of breath, and I've now come to the realization that I can't walk really far like I used to be able to. I used to be able to walk to Alan's with him, and now I'm not able to, which is really annoying because I do like to go see him, but sometimes I have to walk because I don't have a ride. But yeah, the next symptom is aches and pains, which have been big this week. I have been having really bad back pain this week, and it doesn't happen unless I'm sitting like how I am right now. My back's actually starting to hurt right now. I have a heating pad on my back right now, but it's lower down and not up where it's hurting, so I'm gonna have to fix that when I pause. But aches and pains. His kicks sometimes do. I guess his kicks aren't necessarily the things that hurt. It's if he moves a certain way, he hits something and it hurts a little bit, but it's not like a bad pain where I'm like, oh my god, this is like the worst pain in the world. It's just uncomfortable. But I have been having aches and pains. The next symptom is Braxton Hicks. I have had some Braxton Hicks this week, but mostly they were, one day they were when I was home. They weren't too bad. They didn't really hurt. They were just uncomfortable. And then I had Braxton Hicks when I was walking to his place, Alan's place. And it was probably just because of all of the walking and me being out of breath and Grayson not getting enough oxygen. So I started having Braxton Hicks. So I wasn't too concerned about them because they did stop after I sat down and I catched my breath. So I was not too concerned about that. And the last symptom is leaky boobs, which I have not had yet. Thank God. But yeah, those are all the symptoms that I have been having this week or that I could have had. So some other things to talk about is I am now in my third trimester. I'm done with my second trimester. And everybody says, oh, you feel so much tired in your third trimester. And how you feel in your third trimester is how you're going to feel for birth. And I definitely have noticed I've lost a little bit of my energy. I don't have as much as I did in my second trimester. But I'm not to the point where I just want to sleep all day, really. I do have energy to do stuff, but it's mostly at nighttime. During the day, I have, like, no energy to do anything at all. If I go somewhere, I obviously have a little bit more energy, but if I'm just home sitting at home doing nothing, I have no energy to be productive or anything like that. So it is kind of annoying. The next thing is I have been nesting as well, just making sure things are cleaned up. Now I did go for a little while where I kind of like stopped nesting, but then it came back. I want things off the floor. I make sure stuff is organized and all of that kind of stuff. So I just can't wait for the baby shower, which is my next topic. Our baby shower is 100% planned. We have a date, a time, and a place now, so we are just waiting for the date to come and planning everything else, like getting stuff for the baby shower. We've already sent out the invite and everything, so now we're just waiting for the day, which won't be for another month, so I just can't wait to get all of Grayson's stuff and be able to have it all so that we can set it all up and just be all ready for him. And once the room is completely done, I will do a nursery tour, but also I will be doing a baby shower haul as well, because I know some of my fans are probably going to want to know what I got at my baby shower. So I will do a baby shower haul for you. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to film at the baby shower. I think I've talked about this before. It depends on how my mood is and if I actually want to film at the baby shower. But more than likely, I'm not even going to think about it. I'm just going to be enjoying myself and having fun with family. So that is basically probably not going to happen for a baby shower vlog, but there will be a haul of everything that me and Alan get for the baby shower, so don't worry, that video is 100% going to come out. So the last thing to talk about is my cravings this week. So the first craving I've had is McDonald's chicken tenders and french fries. I was really craving them in the beginning of the week, and I ate them, and now I don't crave them anymore, even though french fries sound really good right now, not gonna lie. Again this week, donuts. I'm pretty sure I've talked about donuts before. All this pregnancy, I have been really big into donuts. I had a donut the other day and a croissant for breakfast, which was really good because it filled me up and I felt good that morning. I also had a tea with it, but then I ended up getting sick that night, so it was not the donut's fault, though the donut was bomb. For drinks, Dr. Pepper and Mountain Dew have been really big this week. Just nonstop wanting Dr. Pepper, wanting Mountain Dew for a drink. And I know it's not healthy for me to be drinking so much soda, so I'm trying to limit myself down from that because the caffeine in it isn't good for me to drink, especially when you're pregnant. And the last thing is toast slash breakfast items were really big with me this the beginning of the week. I got cinnamon swirl bread last weekend when I got groceries, and it was literally gone like 2 days later because I was so into eating it. So yeah. Oh, another thing to talk about is, so I'm pretty sure I talked about this in my last update video. I was given acid reflux medicine, but for the past 2 nights I have not taken it because I have not been able to stomach applesauce. It's not the medicine in it that's making me feel nauseous. It's just like the smell of applesauce and just taking it and putting it in my mouth just makes me super duper nauseous. Just the thought of it makes me feel really, really sick. So I think I'm going to have to get pudding instead, because I think that since I've just been eating applesauce every single night, I kind of got sick of it, and Grayson's not liking it right now. So I'm going to try to get some pudding and see if I can eat it that way, because I don't want to go too many days without my acid reflux medicine, because that stuff has been a lifesaver with my acid reflux. So really thankful about that. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do the belly shot now. So here is the front of my belly. Don't mind this. This is just the heating pad, and you'll probably see it on my back when I turn. Here's the side. And then this side, he's definitely getting way bigger. My belly button is like so popped out right now. I'm just waiting for that to pop. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. And I will see you guys all in the next video. Bye guys.